Hi, in this lesson, we will see how to divide two polynomials using the long division method. We'll use these two examples. The first example says 4x raised to the power 3 plus 6x squared minus 2x plus 7 divided by 2x minus 3. We'll use this example and this to understand how to divide using long division method. But before we get into it, I want us to understand some terminologies. The first is the dividend, the second is divisor, the third is quotient, and the fourth is your remainder. Now, take for example, if I'm dividing 92 by 3, we'll say, using the long division method, here I have 92, here I have 3. 92 is my dividend, 3 is my divisor. And my response to this, the answer we'll get is 30. 30 is my quotient. This is my quotient. While this is my dividend, 92, what you have in here is your dividend. Here is my divisor. And obviously the remainder here is 2. Here is my remainder. So at every point in time, your dividend is equal to your divisor multiplied by your quotient, everything added together to your remainder. Now let's see the first question. We have 4x raised to the power 3 plus 6x squared minus 2x plus 7 being divided by 2x minus 3. Obviously, 4x, this here is my dividend, this is my dividend, and what I have here is my divisor. That's my divisor. So that here we can now arrange it this way. Put 4x raised to the power 3 plus 6x squared minus 2x plus 7 and put your divisor out 2x minus 3. Now, the rule of thumb, the operation works this way. You're going to use the first digit here, the coefficient here, to divide everything you have in here one after the other. Let's go through it together. 2x in 4x raised to the power 3, that's 2x squared. Now, I'm going to move 2x squared. I'll multiply everything I have in my divisor. 2x squared times 2x, that's 4x raised to the power 3. 2x squared times minus 3, that's minus 6x squared. Now, we are subtracting what you have here from what you have on top. Now, I'll put a minus sign here. 4x raised to the power 3 minus 4x, that's 0. 6x squared minus 6x minus minus 6x squared, that's 12x squared. Look at it this way. I have a negative sign here and I have my negative here. Minus times minus is plus. It becomes 6x squared plus 6x squared. That's 12x squared minus 2x. What have I done there? All I've done is I've brought my minus 2 down words this way. So that my 4x squared, now my 2x, sorry, 2x again in 12x squared, that's plus 6x. That's plus 6x. 2x times plus 6x, that's 12x squared again. 2x times minus 3, that's minus 18x. Now we'll subtract our 18, we'll subtract our 12x squared from what you have on top. Put a negative sign here. 12x squared minus 12x squared, that's 0. Minus times minus, that's plus 18x. 2 minus 2x plus 18x, that's plus 16x. Now, 2x again in plus 16x, that's plus 8. X will cancel x, see it this way. I have 16x over 2x. X here goes for x. I have 2 here is 1. 2 in 16, that's 8. Now, 8 times 2x, but mind you, I also have brought down my 7. So we're going to bring down 7 this way. Plus 7 is coming down. So when plus 7 comes down, the whole expression here becomes 16x plus 7. Now, 2x now, we've gotten 2x in 16x, that's 8. 8 now multiplied by 2x, that's plus 16x, minus 8 times 3, that's minus 20, 24. 16x We put our minus sign out once again. 16 and 16x, they give way for each other. 16x minus 16x, that's 0. And plus 7. Now, minus minus 24 becomes plus 24. 7 plus 24, that's plus 31. So we can conclude that my dividend, while our dividend is what you have in under here, 4x raised to the power 3 plus 6x squared minus 2x plus 7. This is our dividend. Can conclude this is our dividend. And here is our divisor. But for the required quotient, the required quotient is 2x squared. That's the quotient is 2x squared plus 6x plus 18. And the remainder is 31. That's the remainder. For the second question, I want you to pause the video and give the second question a try. Okay. Now, once again, our dividend is 2x raised to power 2x raised to power 4. So I can write out my dividend. That's 2x raised to power 4 minus 3x raised to power 3 plus x squared minus 4x plus 5. While our divisor is x squared plus 3x plus 1. Now let's get to it. Like we did in our initial place, we're going to use x squared to divide each of the items one after the other. Now, x squared divided by 2x raised to the power 4. That's 2x squared. Now, 2x squared is going to multiply everything I have in my divisor. So, 2x squared times 2x squared times x squared. That's 2x raised to the power 4. Plus 2x squared times 3x. That's 6x raised to the power 3. And 2x squared times 1. That's plus 2x squared. Now, we're going to subtract again. To make it convenient, we'll put a negative sign underneath. 2x raised to the power 4 minus 2x raised to the power 4. It gives way for each other. Minus 3x raised to the power 3 minus 6x raised to the power 3. It becomes minus 9x raised to the power 3. X raised to the power 2 minus 2x squared. It becomes minus x squared. Now, with that, we can now bring down what you have here as your minus 4. Minus 4 is going to come down this way to become minus 4x over here. Now, since that's becoming minus 4x, now, x raised to the power 2, x squared in minus 9x raised to the power 3, that becomes minus 9x. Minus 9x times 9x squared, it becomes minus 9x raised to the power 3 plus, okay, minus 9x now times plus 3. That becomes minus, not plus again. It becomes minus 27x squared. And minus 9x times 1, that's minus 9x. Now let's subtract. To subtract this, let's put a negative sign once again in front. Don't forget your negative sign. I have minus 9 here and I have a negative sign. This obviously is going to become plus 9. 9x raised to the power 3 minus 9x raised to the power 3 plus 9x raised to the power 3. That becomes 0. This 2 is going to become plus 27x squared. Minus x squared plus 27x squared. That's 26x squared. Minus 4x plus 9x, that's plus 5x. Now we are left with this 5. Let's bring it downwards, bring it down this way. It becomes plus 5. Now x squared here in x squared, in 26x squared, that's plus 26. 26 times x squared, that's 26x squared. 26 times 3. 26 times 3, let's just quickly do the multiplication. That's 78. That's plus 78x. And 26 times 1, that's plus 26. We'll subtract once again. Don't forget your negative sign. Put your negative sign in front. Minus 26x squared minus 26x squared, that's 0. 5x minus 78. 5x minus 78, that's minus 73x. That's minus 73x. minus 73x, and I have 5 plus 5 minus 26. 5 minus 26, that's minus 21. With that, you can now see that our remainder